Okay. These lyrics were written by Gene Roddenberry, and I contend that he never intended for them to be used in the Star Trek opening credits. But because he wrote them, and officially they are part of the song, he got another check. And included, he would also get his weekly check for being the richest, you know, TV show creator. But he would also get another greedy check for the song, which he really had no part. He shouldn't have gotten it, taken half of that money. Do you know what I mean? But anyway, it's still kind of, they are kind of incredible lyrics. All right. Ready? Beyond the rim of the starlight. Wait a second. I also want to say, I think these lyrics are written from the point of view of Captain Kirk's lover that he left on Earth to go on journeys throughout the universe. And she's just looking up at the stars going, God, I love that man. I miss his boner. I want him back on Earth giving it to me. Good. And she's jealous that he's out there fucking alien women on different blue planets. Okay, here we go. Beyond the rim of the starlight, my love is wandering in starflight. I know he'll find in star-clustered reaches love, strange love a star woman teaches. And I know his journey ends never. His Star Trek must go on forever. But tell him as he wanders the starry sea, remember me.
Wait till I see that clown. I'm going to give him a piece of my mind. Volunteer for a new mission, will he? I'd like to know who he thinks is going to feed his cat while he's gone. Oh, hello, Captain Hugh. Ready to embark on your mission in your new ship, are you?
I've been looking all over the base for you, Lieutenant.
Well, I see discretion is still a high priority with you, Captain. Don't want anyone to see us together, right? Off to pick up a princess, as I understand it. A mission you have volunteered for. Isn't that so?
Oh, come on. It's not like that, baby.
Don't touch me, you clown. There's been way too much of that already. Maybe it's time we gave each other some space. After all, it's what you and Starfleet are all about, isn't it? Space. Enjoy your princess, you clown, you.
Listen, darling, I have my orders from Starfleet Command. We could work this out later. Beam me up to the space station, Lieutenant.
I'll send your cat up as well. Whoa. Son of a bitch, clown. First they want to show you their big top, and then the curtain comes crashing down on you. Oh, I think I love him.
Must get through that airship.
We will, sir. Once we kidnap the princess, we can force her father, King Roman, to give us the combination to the airship.
Captain Hughes.
Admiral Kirk.
Welcome to Starbase 11. I understand you volunteered for this mission. Why, Hugh? Why?
Well, sir, if I may, my life kind of requires some space right now, and well, I understand that the Princess Ioana needs a transport from her own planet Adoria to the space station in the Alderaan system for her inauguration. So,
let me make this perfectly clear, Captain. You're to arrive at planet Adora and introduce yourself to the princess in a diplomatic manner. Your mission is one of transport. Do I make myself clear, Captain?
Yes, sir, I am.
And Captain, if you should just happen to have some fun on the way, just be discreet. There's a shuttle waiting for you to take you to the new Enterprise. You're dismissed, Captain.
Yes, sir, Admiral. Thank you, sir.
We ain't found...
...battled the entire Space Ball Army.
My hair! He shot my hair!
Holy... ...and escaped the clutches of Dark Helmet.
I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
Abandon ship. Proceed to escape pods.
What's the matter with this sea?
When does this happen in the movie?
Give me bomb. How do I know you don't make a face for me?
Captain, the Enterprise, 1701A, bigger, better, and faster.
Yeah, she's quite a sight, all right, Ensign. Just get me on board so we can get on with our mission.
May I ask where we will be going, Captain?
Sure, no big secret anyhow, you're coming with us. We're on our way to pick up the Princess Ioana on her home planet, Adoria.
Adoria?
You know the planet, Ensign?
Well, as I understand it, sir... It's a planet with nothing but some of the most beautiful women in the galaxy, all looking for the opposite sex on other worlds for procreation, sir.
That may be so, Ensign, but our mission is just to take the princess to her inauguration to become queen of planet Adoria. So keep your pants on and let's move it, shall we? We have a ship to get on tonight.
Yes, sir.
Captain on deck. Secure ship for immediate departure. Captain Hugh, please report to the bridge.
Doctor, I don't understand why I'm here.
Well, we're about to beam down to an alien planet to breed a princess, and we can't take the chance we would infect the population with any diseases, can we? So it only makes sense, my dear, that we take physicals first to ensure we don't wipe out a whole civilization.
And just what type of disease do you expect to detect from inside of me, Doctor?
Well, Seven, you're an extremely beautiful woman. I would like to think you're quite active sexually. And we can't have anything spreading now, can we?
I can assure you, Doctor, that I have no reservations about jumping someone's bones. But I would leave the captain and the other crew members for only a few moments to greet the princess. I hardly think I could find the time to infect a whole planet's population.
Oh, I'm thrilled to hear that, Seven. It doesn't hurt to have these exams to make sure. And besides, I kind of enjoy the view from my observation table. Plus the fact the captain ordered his exams. He records them to watch later. I told him, damn it, Hugh, I'm a doctor, not a film producer. And as far as jumping someone's bones goes, my dear, well, you know that's my nickname, right?
Oh, is it, Doctor?
Attention, this is the bridge. 7 of 9, please report immediately to the shuttle bay for a launch sequence diagnostic.
Well, I certainly should hope to see you later, Doctor. And I hope at that time, you will have a bone we can share together.
Beginning to think I can cure a rainy day.
Captain? We have arrived and are entering the orbit of planet Adoria.
Excellent navigation. Establish orbit and inform the landing crew to assemble at the transporter to beam down to the planet's surface and greet the princess. You will be in charge, number two, while we beam down. The landing party will be composed of myself, Dr. McCoy, Warts, Seven of Nine, Deanna, and Angelina.
Captain! No princess for me, sir?
How you dress after duty in your quarters and on a holodeck is no concern of mine, number two.
That's not what I meant, sir.
I should hope not, number two. I've seen your legs.
So I'm to remain here, then, in orbit while you greet the princess on a planet full of beautiful women, sir? Here, on the bridge?
Yes, the bridge, number two. I am quite confident you can handle that, right? Just don't be passing gas in my command chair anymore. It's starting to take its toll on the leather.
But, sir, I...
That's a high priority, number one, number two. No gas.
Aye, aye, sir. It's not fair, you frickin' clown.
I'm sorry, what was that, number two?
Yes, sir. Nothing, sir. Gas. I got it. All hands, standard orbit. Something wrong, Deanna?
High warp tachyon field detected, sir.
Mr. LaForge? Where?
Right here, sir.
Well, I am sensing an alien life form.
I see no life form, Counselor. Just a blue pulsating light.
Should I call for more security, Captain?
For a light warp? You don't like blue?
Looks like it's an old English police call box. And now I'm detecting that there is someone inside of it.
See? What did I tell you, Will? An alien life form.
All right, everybody. Keep your panties on, Worf.
I can assure you I have my panties on, sir.
No, Worf. See what it is.
Yes, sir.
Well, it's opening.
Excuse me, may I help you with something?
Ah, yes. Well, it's a good day to you, that very large friend. Hope you don't mind me parking here a moment. See, I'm looking for a friend of mine. A princess, if you will. Princess Yuana, and I do. not much of a sense of humor, eh? Well, perhaps if I could speak to you, Well, good day indeed, my dear. Please tell me you are the captain of this magnificent vessel.
Oh, heavens, no.
No? Well, pity then. 1,000 men would gladly break the box of such beauty.
Well, thank you so very much, sir.
Ah, well, you must be the captain then. Alas, we meet.
I'm second in command, Will Riker. The captain is unavailable at the moment, taking care of some important business. And if you don't mind me asking, just who are you, sir?
Who indeed? That is the name, sir. Dr. Who.
You're kidding.
Will, it's who?
Who will?
I will. Who?
Sorry, I don't have time for the old who's on first.
I'm not on anything, Will.
Warp, take the good doctor here to the captain's ready room. I will inform the captain of his presence.
Yes, sir. If you will follow me, Doctor.
Presents. Oh, I just love presents. Tell me, Warp, are all the women this beautiful on the ship? How happy you must be.
It's Warp, not Warp.
Or not.
Wait here. The captain will be here shortly.
Clouds.
Thank you.
Well, it's time. The Earth landing party has just requested an audience with the princess.
Should I return a reply of a granted request to their ship, Goodnight? I'm a little bit nervous.
Oh, don't worry. You're going to be just fine. Put on a good show, Princess, and you will be rewarded accordingly.
Well, Deanna, one thing is for certain. We won't be seeing any good-looking available men on this mission. It's all women.
I just can't wait to see the princess and palace.
We're not seeing the whole palace, Deanna. Just the princess and her receiving chamber.
What? No time to visit? Or shop? Captain, why am I going?
I just don't understand why we can't take the shuttle down to the planet's surface, Captain. I signed on to this ship to practice medicine, not to have my atoms scattered back and forth across space by this gadget.
The bones are starting to sound like Spock.
If you're gonna get nasty, I'm gonna leave.
May the fleas of a thousand targs infest your enemy's camps. I am hoping we shall become great friends along our journey together, Captain. I am looking forward to seeing your great, how do you call it, starship?
Thank you, I thank your majesty. We have the very best of accommodations ready for you and your consort at any time you are ready to leave, your majesty.
Captain Hugh, if we are to become friends along the way, I would prefer you call me Yuana. Besides, I'm not crowned as of yet.
I understand, Yuana.
Something is humorous, Captain?
Well, it's just that your request for me to call you Yuana because all my friends call me Yes I Do.
Well, I see. We will get along just fine, Captain. With a sense of humor like that, we shall go far together. I have some matters of state to attend to, Captain. So if you don't mind, my consort and I shall follow you up to your ship shortly.
I will send my second-in-command to see you up when you are ready. Thank you, Yuana.
Captain Hugh.
Enterprise 6 to beam up.
They are expecting us shortly, and we must pack for our long journey to the inauguration. Excellent, Yuana. This is going to work out better than I thought. You must keep up this appearance at all times, Yuana. I mean, Your Royal Highness. Well, we can't keep the good captain, Yes I Do, waiting, can we?
Thank you. So, what did you think of the Princess Bones? Beautiful, isn't she?
Damn it, I'm a Dr. Hugh, not a bloody judge for a beauty contest.
So, what is your professional medical opinion of the princess then, Doctor?
Pure speculation and just an educated guess, I'd say that woman is alive and extremely hot looking, Captain.
Well, I'm glad to see your glands are still working, Bones.
Personally, I'm just surprised no one's died yet. I'm sick of having to say, he's dead, Hugh.
It's still early, Doctor. Maybe we could find you someone. Security to the bridge.
All right, cut it out, Captain.
Captain, so we meet at long last, sir.
Comfortable? May I ask what you're doing sitting at my desk with your feet up?
Sorry, Captain. Wait a minute. We have been introduced.
I know who you are, Doctor. I need to know why you are.
Oh, I see. Well, that's good to hear by your security officer, Warp. I can be pressed by a rather blunt gentleman named Will on your, bridge.
I understand that, sir, and I'm not talking about my office. I mean my ship. Now, just what is your purpose here, Doctor?
Ah, yes. Right to the thick of things, Captain. I like that. I am quite simply here to escort the princess to inauguration, Captain, as per request by a ruling council on her planet.
Well, we were asked to do the same as per request of the princess herself, and by the orders of the Federation of Planets and Starfleet Command. And as you can see, Doctor, we are well on our way to accommodate everyone's wishes.
Captain, although your ship is no doubt fascinating and quite plush, I have the means of transportation that can take her there almost instantaneously instead of a few days. So why trouble yourself with the task?
In that phone booth, sir? Doctor, will you also be supplying security after arriving a few days ahead on the space station as well, arriving early?
Security? What is it for?
Well, let's say there are those who wish to stop her from becoming Queen of Adora and receiving her crown.
That is, I suppose, a possibility I haven't considered, my good Captain. But I'm still requested by those who govern over the princess, and I am very good at diplomatic relations.
I'm sorry, Doctor. I have my orders from Starfleet Command, and I'm afraid I can't allow you to take the princess anywhere. However, if you wish to travel along with us, this can be arranged, and I will have Number 2 assign you living quarters for our journey. I will have him put you close to the princess so that you can see that things are all going well.
Well, thank you ever so much for your generosity, Captain. But I still have to contact the ruling council on this matter before I accept your kind offer.
As you wish, but I stand firm on my decision.
Until then, Captain.
Doctor?
Oh, God! Another telemarketer. Here's how to get rid of them. Watch this. Enterprise, may I help you? Captain Hugh, yes, he's here. Do you wish to speak to him? Yes, of course you can. I'll put him right on. May I have your credit card number, expiration date, and 3-number passcode, please? Well, Captain Hugh is available, and he can speak to you right away, sir. I understand. Well, the captain's time is very valuable to Starfleet, and we have to charge you a $200 a minute fee. Oh, I see. You don't wish to pay. Is that right? Well, perhaps if you give me your home phone number, I can have him call you later when he's off duty. Well, I see. So basically, you don't wish to have people calling and annoying you. Is that right, sir? Right. Yes, nice speaking to you as well. Now may I have that credit card number, please? Well, no, sir. It's for our conversation. Well, I'm not exactly free either, sir. Hello? Hello? Works every time. And they won't be calling back.
Well, come in, Number 2.
Wanted to see me, Captain?
Yes, well, before we receive the communique from the surface that the princess is ready to beam up, I need you to take Deanna and beam down to the palace so that she could have some time to look around for a while first, or I will never hear the end of it. Take Worf and leave him with her for security. Then, when we receive word that the princess is ready, I need you to beam up with her and escort the princess and her consort Goodnight to the bridge.
An escort? Well, things are looking up. No problem, sir. I'll beam down immediately, sir.
Make it so, number two.
Worf, Indiana, report to the transporter.
Captain, there's a message coming in from Starfleet Command, sir.
Put the message through here, Uhura.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Captain Hugh. Had your princess yet?
Nurse Chapel. I haven't done anything, darling. What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
It's your cat. Somehow he got left behind. I suppose I'm to feed it and take care of him while you're off on your conquest of royalty?
Yes, please, if it's not too much trouble.
Oh, of course not, Captain. I can also clean the whole apartment while you're off. Wax the floors, maybe, and scrub and buff the car.
Sorry, Lieutenant. We seem to be losing...
You know I can still see you, right, Hugh?
I have to... Uhura?
Sir?
Damn it. Next time, tell me who it is before connecting me.
Yes, of course, Captain, sir. Sorry.
Sorry, Uhura.
Excuse me.
What? Again with the security? Really, Worf? I'm beginning to see a pattern.
Riker to Enterprise, we've had a situation here. Beam down more security.
Well, so much for the 1,000 credits I owed him for playing poker.
There were others from security. You owed him that game as well.
Oh, shit!
Oh. Yep.
Back to work. Back to work. Everybody, work, 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 work.
Captain, the Unilab unit and I have run a diagnostic on your personal shuttle. It did need some adjustments to the command chair. It seems to be deteriorating from some unknown source. At any rate, we replaced it. Anything else, Captain?
Yes, there is something else, Seven. Please inform number two to stay out of my personal transport and alert security. He is banned from it as well. I'm going to go to lunch now. We're near a station I like to frequent whenever we're in this sector of space. I shall return shortly. Please inform the bridge.
Well, if you will excuse me, Captain Hugh, I need to go to the sick bay and see Dr. McCoy.
Didn't you already have an exam, Seven?
Yes, sir, I did have an exam, but this is on a personal note, sir. I believe you may have a bone to pick with me. That is, I hope so.
I see. Well, as long as your other duties are complete, you are dismissed. And have fun.
Thank you, Captain. Worf.
Deanna, seen enough of the palace and ready to go back to the ship?
Yes, I'm ready. You know, being on a planet with nothing but women on it, you tend to miss having a strong man around.
Worf to Enterprise.
Worf.
Mm-hmm. Where's the egg?
Oh my god, Dwarf. I wanted to be together, but not like this.
Don't panic, the Ensign will fix this. Isn't that right, Ensign?
I am sorry, sir. The transporter must have mixed your signals and only registered one person beaming up. You must have been too close to one another.
What are you implying, Ensign? This is our fault?
It's not that bad, sir. You look really, really hot.
Fix this immediately, Ensign, or else.
I'm sorry for laughing, sir, but you look so fragile and so much less intimidating this way.
Really? How about now? This could be an interesting development. I'm feeling rather dirty, Ensign. I'm going to my quarters to take a shower, fix this transporter, and then call me in about an hour.
I'm Leonard Nimoy. The following tale is true, and by true, I mean false. It's all lies, but they're entertaining lies. And in the end, isn't that the real truth? The answer is no.
All this power surging and throbbing, yet under control.
If I were human, I believe my response would be...
I can love you.
Are you all right, Deanna? You seem a little nervous.
Well, I'm thrilled, of course, to be able to help the princess to get to her inauguration. But what if there are others trying to stop her? This could become somewhat a dangerous mission. Don't you think so, Captain Hue?
From who? That Doctor Who character? Please, he's no more of a threat than my cat.
Excuse me, Captain Who?
The Princess Yuana and her consort.
Good day, Captain. Are we ready to get on the way?
Welcome to the bridge, Yuana, and yes, please come and have a seat for a spell next to me and enjoy the view from Number 2's chair as we embark on our journey and leave the orbit of your beautiful planet.
Well, as long as Will doesn't feel put out...
Don't mind being put out, do you, Number 2?
As long as you don't mean put out like your cat, Captain. And no, of course not, Your Highness.
Please call me Yuana, Will.
Yuana? Will what, Your Highness?
Stop at Number 2 or you will be shown the door.
The door, Captain?
Airlock, to be specific, Number 2.
1,000 pardons, Your Highness. I should like to take my leave and prepare our room. Anything you say... I mean, yes... Your excuse, good night, Your Highness.
You're quite fond of your consort, aren't you, Princess? She really is quite stunning. Has she been a good friend, and in your service, for very long?
Yes. Well, we are almost like sisters since we were children. Sometimes I forget she is a servant. The view here is quite spectacular, Captain. But if you don't mind, I must retire to my quarters. There is much preparation I must do before the inauguration.
Of course, Yuana, as you wish. Will escort you to your room.
That's really not necessary, Captain. I know my way.
No problem. You are free to do as you choose while on board. Well, shall I see you later then, Yuana? If you like, I can show you around and give you the proverbial 25-cent tour.
I have no idea what a 25 cent is, Captain. Is that some type of fragrance?
I'm sorry, sometimes I make no sense.
I hear that.
Yes, that would be wonderful, Captain. Shall we say after dinner?
It's a date. I shall show you our engine room and our means of propulsion.
Yes?
I have a petition here to stop the Space Channel from showing so much Star Trek. Could I please get your signature?
What show?
Star Trek.
Find out where that transmission
is coming from. Star Trek the original. Star Trek Deep Space Nine and Star Trek Voyager. It's all they play. The only people that watch this crap live in their basement and have no lives. It's gotta stop, and will you please sign my petition?
Well, I still don't know what you're talking about, but I'll get my son to sign for you. Gary, get up here, dear. He lives in the basement. Such a nice boy.
Doc!
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Do ha jopa doc hasta. Charkum Raj.
You keep getting me killed. I thought you had my back.
Oh, not again.
Hold on just a minute. Okay. We're both too old for this kind of thing.
All right, now you're overacting.
Is that it? That was friggin' awesome. Hey, where'd everyone go? Well, here we are. This way, Ioana.
Thank you, Captain.
Well, here she is, the heart of the Enterprise, the warp core. Capable of traveling 0.7 light years in 2 hours when at maximum warp. That is equivalent to the speed of 3,066 times the speed of light. The structural integrity field up above holds the antimatter and then converts it in the chamber above that.
Very impressive, Captain Hue, and very beautiful as well. It all sounds very technical, Captain, but I'm afraid I really can't appreciate it as you do, only its beauty.
Well, I do understand, and its beauty as well, and I see your point. These are the controls for the navigation.
Well, I do understand some things of navigation in a three-dimensional plane. These controls are similar to those on our private shuttle, though our means of propulsion differs, and quite slower, which is why we asked for your assistance. The look of this warp core reminds me of the falls in our planet's equator. Quite stunning, as well as all of your crew, Captain.
Well, I have to agree with you once again, Ioana. I'm afraid that's pretty much all there is, Princess. I hope you enjoyed it.
Well, I never thought I would ever see so many stunning things in an engine room that were so hypnotizing, Captain.
Yes, well, once again, I have to agree, Ioana. Absolutely hypnotized.
Well, we still have the holodeck to look forward to this evening.
Well, Ioana, this is going to be something special I am sure that you are going to enjoy.
I don't understand so far the clothing attire. There's so much material. I can feel the gravity of the cloth pulling down. and every inch of my body is covered.
Well, it's all in the spirit of the program we are about to enter called the holodeck. We can transform it to any location we want, and we have it set for a nightclub in our early history, and this is the type of attire that they wore.
Yes, I see, Captain Hugh. That was my understanding of the program, and I can't wait to experience it. Even my consort, Goodnight, is eager to participate. She has a number she wanted to do from Earth 1930s. She is really quite a marvelous singer.
Well, shall we, Ioana? Worf Indiana will be joining us. They're holding a table for us. This way.
Me and Spock, we met a nasty Nazi alien. He locked our asses up. We found a hunk of grizzly and a metal piece of bed. We made a laser phaser gun and shot him in the head. Bust a move, dog. I was standing on the bridge when Sulu came to me. His eyes were full of tears. He said, Captain, can't you see? The ship is gonna blow to something I besiege. I grabbed the treble and some chewing gum and stopped the Warcore breach. I say, bounce a graviton particle beam off the main deflector dish. That's the way we do things, lad. We're making shit up as we wish. The Klingons and the Romulans pose no threat to us, cause if we find we're in a bind, we just make some shit up.
Do you like it, you wanna? I can't wait to hear your consort Goodnight sing.
Though he's just a child, and some think him a twit, Wesley is the master when it comes to making up some shit. He's the guy you want with you when you go out in space. Now if only he could beam those pimples off his face. And if you're at a party on the Starship Enterprise, and the karaoke player just plain old up and dies, set up a neutrino field inside a can of peas, hold on to Geordi's visor and sing into Data's knee. And I say, bounce a graviton particle beam off the main deflector dish. That's the way we do things, lad. We're making shit up as we wish. The Klingons and the Romulans pose no threat to us, cause if we find we're in a bind, we just make some shit up. Sisko's on a mission to go no bloody place. He loiters on a space station above Bajoran space. The wormhole opened up and now they come from near and far. We'll keep the booze but please send back the fucking Jem'Hadar. What is with the Klingons? Remember in the day, they looked like Puerto Ricans and they dressed in gold lamé. Now they look like heavy metal rockers from the dead, with leather pants and frizzy hair and lobsters on their heads. And I say, bounce a graviton particle beam off the main deflector dish. That's the way we do things, lad, we're making shit up as we wish. The Klingons and the Romulans, they pose no threat to us, cause if we bind, we're in a bind, we just make some shit up. We were looking for a way to make the ratings soar, so we orchestrated an encounter with the Borg. Normally you think that that would get us into shit, but this one has a smashing ass and a lovely set of tits. And I say, bounce a graviton particle beam off the main deflector dish. That's the way we do things, lad, we're making shit up as we wish. The Klingons and the Romulans pose no threat to us, cause if we find we're in a bind, we're totally screwed, but never mind, we'll pull something out of our behind. We just make some shit up.
Oh,
This must be your consort Goodnight's act. My God, she's beautiful.
Wow, that's your consort Goodnight? I've never even noticed her before.
Captain, I'm somehow sure most men probably make that same mistake.
Some other men do. Get out of here. Give me some money too. You're sitting down.
Captain! Good, he's coming around. Are you all right, Captain?
Wow, I just had my whole life flash before my eyes since I'd left on this mission. Everything from Starfleet headquarters and Nurse Chapel to the Consort Goodnight's performance. What happened, Bones? Why am I in sickbay?
It seems that you collapsed on the holodeck, Captain. Worf told me the last thing you said was how beautiful the Consort Goodnight was, and they hit the floor like a ton of bricks.
So, any damages, Bones?
I can't tell. You landed on your face.
Funny, Bones. Do you torture all your patients this way?
Well, I'm a doctor, Hugh, not a bloody fortune teller. I need time to gather all the facts, Captain.
I passed out. That's enough facts.
Insufficient facts always invites danger, Captain.
Oh, shut up, Spock.
I cannot obey your order, Captain.
Spock's right, Captain. You can't just get up and go back to work, and that's the end of it.
Am I to understand the two of you agree on something? Spock,
A most unpleasant situation, Captain.
Then this truly is the end.
It could be just stress, Hugh. That, or a sudden jolt of love's infatuation for the princess's consort.
Is that possible, Spock?
I'm not capable of that emotion.
Why, you cold-blooded hobgoblin. This is the captain we're talking about.
Restrain your leaps of illogic. I have said nothing. I was merely speculating.
Come on, Bones. I have a gathering on 10-4 for the princess. I can't keep her waiting. You could put a monitor on me and keep track of me that way. Lying around here will accomplish nothing.
Well, you've always been a pain in my backside, Captain. And I guess there's no sense in me having to put up with you driving me crazy in my sickbay. Go ahead, go. But if you're at your party, who's in charge of the ship?
Doctor, I am in command of the Enterprise.
Oh, God help us all.
Why, thank you, Doctor.
Okay, so the monitor, Bones? The one you're gonna put on me? Bones, what are you looking at?
Bones, isn't that Sofia Vergara?
I know that I have an accent, but people understand me just fine.
What did she just say?
Beauty precedes you, Princess. I'm the Doctor, and I've been sent here by the planet's counselors to escort you to the inauguration.
Please, you may refer to me as you want a doctor.
You want a doctor for what? Are you feeling ill?
Very funny, Doctor. However, the good Captain Hugh and the Enterprise are taking me to the inauguration as per my personal request. So you needn't bother, kind sir, and you may inform the Andorian consulate of this as well.
I see. Well, Captain Clown has just assigned me to a room for you down the hall. And we shall speak again soon, Princess.
Sir, did you wanna?
Yes. And a good evening to you, Wop. Greetings, Captain. Once again, who meets who?
Good evening, Doctor. Can I help you with something?
Not really, Captain. I simply have a question for the Princess Consort.
You mean Goodnight?
She's known as Goodnight?
Yes, a good night indeed.
Ah, I see. Well, Goodnight. I'm looking for the Princess. Do you know of her whereabouts?
Yes, Doctor, I do. Just what is your business with her?
Well, I just have a few things clear up between her and the Andorian's consul.
I suppose that will be fine, Doctor. She is in her quarters getting ready for the festivities here.
Well, in that case, I was speaking my leave. Goodbye.
She's on deck C, berth 4, Doctor. If you wish, I could have security escort you.
That won't be necessary, Captain. I'm perfectly capable of finding it. Thank you again.
So anyhow, as I was saying goodnight, I was so impressed with the number you sang in the holodeck and your Jessica Rabbit outfit. Well, you looked fantastic. Are you single as well?
Fascinating.
Bach, please just go find something to do while I speak to Goodnight.
I cannot obey your order, Captain.
Why, Spock, why? Just go find your own girl.
That, sir, is illogical.
Spock, I swear you're crowding my style.
Go to hell.
Spock!
Evil does seek to maintain power by suppressing the truth.
You're becoming really irritating, Spock.
Irritating? Ah, yes. One of your Earth emotions.
You heard the captain. Beat it, Spock, or else.
As you wish. Your illogical approach does have its advantages on occasion, Captain. At any rate, the game is yours.
That was freaking awesome! Poor Spock. May I, escort you to your room, Goodnight?
Doctor Who?
Good evening, Your Highness. I was hoping I could speak to you alone.
Well, I suppose so. I was just on my way to the celebration. The captain has arranged for me in there. 10 Forward, I think it's called.
What I need to ask, I want to take a moment of time, Princess. If I may be allowed to enter.
Well, come in, Doctor.
Thank you so very much, Princess.
Please call me Ioana.
Yes, of course. And might I say, you look absolutely ravishing in that gown, Princess.
Why, thank you, Doctor.
Well...
So what is it that you need to see me about?
Well...
Don't be shy, Doctor. Just tell me.
As you know, your planet's council has asked me personally to take you to the inauguration, I'm afraid this clown in charge of this vessel is rather stubborn. You see, he leaves me a little no choice.
No choice about what, Doctor? What is that contraption?
This, Princess. A sonic screwdriver, Your Highness. I'm terribly sorry about this. You'll be safe with me, darling.
Who?
No laughing. There's no. You see, laugh. In parentheses, and say laugh. It's not there. Stop it. You're not sticking to the script. Oh, lovey kitten. Okay, so.
Doctor Who?
Doctor Who?
Doctor Who?
Here you go.
Scene one, Apple, take two.
Good evening, Princess. I was hoping I could speak to you alone for just a moment.
Well, I suppose so. I was just on my way to the celebration. The captain has arranged for me in there. 10 Forward, I think it's called.
Well, what I need to ask you will just take a moment of your time, Princess, if I may be allowed to enter.
Well, come in, Doctor.
Thank you so very much, Your Highness.
Please call me Ioana.
Yes, of course. May I also add how amazing you look in that gown. Can you take that bra off?
Well,
I'm sorry. That's not a bra, is it? That is your gown. Okay, go ahead. So, might I say how absolutely amazing in that gown, Princess?
Why, thank you, Doctor. So, what is it that you need to see me about?
Well, I...
Don't be shy, Doctor. Just tell me.
Okay, I want you to take that top off. I'm a one-track mind doctor.
I see that.
That was freaking awesome! Poor Spock.
May I, escort you to your room, good night?
Commanding my own ship, full of beautiful young women such as yourselves. You're an Orion slave girl, aren't you, sweetheart?
Why, yes, I am, Admiral. And I just adore a strong man of great power in uniform.
Well, I do have great power. But what do you say we go to my quarters and lose the uniforms? You know, I lost one of you in my green silk sheets once. But fortunately, she found me. Well, let's see, there's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
But what about Sunday, Admiral? Any room for seconds?
Oh, I'm sorry, my dear. Never ever on a Sunday. That's my day of rest. God, I love outer space.
Enter!
Pardon the intrusion, Captain, but there's been a development with our guest, Doctor Who, sir.
Yes, Worf, what is it?
Well, sir, security was alerted of a time warp signature emanating from the Princess Ioana's quarters on C-Deck.
What? I thought you said Doctor Who, Worf.
Yes, sir. Well, it appears they are both missing from the Enterprise according to our internal scanners. We could only assume that the good doctor has kidnapped the princess from her quarters using that phone booth contraption of his.
You mean the TARDIS, Worf? I want an immediate deep full scan of the quadrant looking for that time warp signature, Worf, although I am fairly sure where they are heading.
Yes, Captain, right away, sir.
There's no need for that, Captain.
Excuse me, good knight, but the Princess Ioana is missing, and we suspect that good Doctor Who is the culprit.
That's quite all right, Captain. We were expecting this to happen. And quite frankly, I was beginning to wonder what was taking so long.
What are you talking about, good knight?
Well, Captain, I'm afraid we've deceived you and Starfleet a little bit. You see, Ioana is really the consort, and I am the true princess. of Adoria.
I just slept with the Princess of Adoria? Starfleet will have my butt in a sling for sure.
Even a princess needs her recreation, Captain. And I hope it meant more than that for both of us. And don't worry about your butt. I can protect it. You see, the planet's consulate knew once I became queen that I had planned on dispersing them and removing their position altogether. They are nothing but a group of old maids with nothing but self-interests at heart and not the welfare of my planet. Power and greed being their only motivation. I assumed they would try to pull something like this, so we put on this little ruse to deter them.
But what about Ioana? She's still missing.
She will be fine, Hugh. Once the fools realize they have kidnapped the wrong person, they won't harm her, knowing I love her dearly and what I would do to them if they did.
So, this Doctor Who character was in on it as well, darling?
No, Captain. Doctor Who is innocent as well. He was only trying to help my planet, but being deceived by the consulate as well. Did you just call me darling? Promise me no harm will come to him, Hugh. Especially seeing my consort Lucy has fallen deeply in love with him, and he with her as well.
Lucy? I thought her name was Ioana.
Well, actually, Captain, that's the nickname Lucy gave to me when we were growing up together, so we used it to confuse the consort. She gave me that nickname because I used to constantly ask her, do you want to go out and chase boys? Before the Great War killed all of our men, that is. So she started calling me Ioana, and the consulate knew this.
No harm then sitting back and letting them think they have succeeded in their task. We should be at the space station for the inauguration bar tomorrow anyhow, and I will personally beam down with you to assure your crown, Your Majesty.
Thank you, Captain, and I am sorry for deceiving you like this, but I thought it would be best you didn't know. And apparently it worked. Please call me darling again.
Delay those orders, Worf, and we shall speak of your security's performance later. I want you to send a message to the Planet Adorian's consulate of the kidnapping. Tell them that we are currently searching for her. It is imperative that we keep up the appearance that they have succeeded with their plot.
As you wish, Captain.
You're dismissed, Worf.
Yes, sir.
And as for you, Captain, may I escort you to your room this time, darling?
Your Highness, who am I to deny the future ruler of a whole planet?
Well, not yet, but whatever works for you.
Yes, darling. This is it. No need to be nervous. Let's go, darling. We'll beam down.
Yeah.
darling. I'm so very pleased that you were here to greet me. Did you miss me?
Get off. I'm not here to see you, clown.
Come on, sweetheart. I had my orders from Starfleet. What could I do? I thought you would show me a little forgiveness.
Forgiveness? Really? After what you put me through? Well, I'm afraid you're too late for forgiveness, Captain. If you want forgiveness, better speak to a priest. We're past all that now anyhow, aren't we, Hugh? Besides, I kind of have a new boyfriend now.
What? New boyfriend? Well, I see you didn't wait long, did you?
So? What of it? You're off in space chasing who knows what's tail weeks at a time, and I'm stuck here at Starfleet no more than a cat sitter for you. Well, enough of that then, Captain. Vader treats me like a princess instead of a house sitter, and that's who I'm meeting up with, if you must know.
A princess, eh? You know, they're not always what they appear to be, darling.
Hold it, mister. Those cost 20 credits apiece. Not 20 credits a dozen.
I am altering the deal. Pray I don't alter it any further.
Oh, God. It's him.
Who?
My boyfriend, Darth.
Darth? What is that, European?
Now play nice. He's a bit on the dark side, if you get my meaning, and has a bit of a short temper. Darth, darling. This is Captain Hugh, that I spoke to you of.
Impressive. Indeed you are powerful, as the Emperor has foreseen.
Darth. This is your boyfriend?
I find your lack of faith disturbing. You don't know the power of the dark side.
What dark side? It's in the middle of the afternoon.
Don't make me destroy you.
The only thing you're going to destroy is this scene.
I was just explaining to Captain Hugh that we were over, Darth, and that I'm with you now.
So, you have accepted the truth. It is pointless to resist, my son. It is your destiny.
Glad to see you quit smoking there, Darth. Even if it is a little too late. I think it's in bad taste you leaving me like this, Nurse Chapel.
Your powers are weak, old man. Perhaps you think you're being treated unfairly.
He's a very powerful man and works high in the ranks of the Empire. Plus, I think he's just really handsome in his jet-black shiny suit. It kind of reminds me of latex. And somehow, it just turns me on.
And now, Your Highness, we will discuss the location of your hidden rebel base.
Lovely. Sorry, Hugh. We're off, then. Are you all right, Bar?
I'm fine. I just need to go to the toilet. Why did I have to say I was going to the toilet? No one says that out loud. Come on, Vader, pull yourself together. She's just a woman.
There's something familiar about all this.
Captain Hugh, you've returned. You left so suddenly at the inauguration, I thought you were gone for good.
Just temporarily, Your Majesty. I had some things to clear up on Earth first. But it's all been taken care of now, and I'm back. That is, if it meets with your approval, Your Majesty.
Well, I certainly hoped for a longer period this time, Captain Darling.
Well, actually, Your Highness, I have accumulated over a year of backlog vacation time. And I thought, we would spend it together.
A year? Well, I guess that will have to do for now. How can I deny a great captain of a whole starship? May I show you to your room now, please?
Well, I thought you would never ask, my queen.
Look good on a resume!